horizontal and vertical displacements of a projectile are given by x is equal to 5t and y is equal to 12t minus 5t square. Find its range, x in meters and t in seconds. Here the problem, x displacement, this is horizontal displacement and this is vertical displacement. Now let us take the standard equations. We know that horizontal displacement x is equal to ux into t or u cos theta into t, which is equal to from the given data 5t. Similarly, let us call it as equation 1. Vertical displacement y is equal to uy into t minus half gt square or u sin theta into t minus half gt square. Now from the first equation, ux is equal to 5. Second equation, uy is equal to 12, since this is given as 12t minus 5t square, and half g is equal to 5 implies g is equal to 10. So we know ux, uy and also g. Our aim is to calculate range. We know that range r is equal to 2 into ux into uy by g. So if we calculate using this components equation, problem will be simple. 2 into 5 into 12 divided by 10. So here this 5 to 10, 10 gets cancelled. The remaining is 12. So data problem suggests some x horizontal displacement, y vertical displacement. So we compared with the standard equation, x is equal to ux into t or u cos theta into t, y is equal to uy into t minus half gt square. First one directly will get ux, that is 5, but here uy is 12, and also it is compulsory to calculate g value using this equation only. Comparison from this only, we'll come to know g value as 10 meter per second square. Substitute these things into this equation. Suppose we are interested in the maximum height calculation, same thing, h is equal to u y square by 2g. Already we know u y is nothing but 12, so 12 into 12 by 2 into 10. So this is 2, 6 times, so this becomes equal to 72 by 10, 7.2 meters. Similarly, we can calculate time of flight. It is 2 uy by g. So 2 into 12 by 10. So 24 by 10, nothing but 2.4 seconds. So using these component equations, it becomes easy to find the values. Now let us consider another example. The coordinates of a moving particle are given by y is equal to 8t minus 5t square and x is equal to 60. Find the initial velocity of a projection. So problem is the same. First equation, y is given, it is equal to 8t minus 5t square. So if I compare with our standard equation, uy into t minus half gt square. Here I am interested, what is uy? So comparison gives uy is equal to 8. Now let us take x equation. X is given as 6t, which is equal to ux into t, implies ux is equal to 6. Once we know the horizontal and vertical components of initial velocities, the net velocity of projection is nothing but ux square plus uy square under root. It is 6 square plus 8 square. 6 square is 36, 8 square is 64, total is root 100, nothing but 10 meter per second.